Major pharmaceutical companies spent millions upon millions of dollars in the midterms this year and all throughout the year, actually, to defeat marijuana legalization in states where that was on the ballot. Now, there's a reason for this, and it's something we've discussed in the past, but I want to talk about it again because the new numbers coming out are even more shocking than the previous numbers that we had discussed. A few years ago, or about a year or two ago, I guess it was, the numbers were that if all 50 states passed marijuana legalization legislation, Big Pharma would lose almost $4 billion every single year. Well, now, because more and more Americans are spending more and more money on prescription drugs, if all 50 states legalize marijuana tomorrow, Big Pharma would start losing $6 billion every single year. $6 billion a year. So in just the last year or two, the number that Americans are spending on pharmaceuticals has increased by $2 billion per year. That's what that means. So if we legalize marijuana, both recreational and medicinal, obviously, that's $6 billion out of the pockets of these greedy and dangerous pharmaceutical companies who lie to you about the dangers of their products. They hide the dangers and they pay their very well-paid drug pushers to go out there and tell your doctor that whether you need it or not, they'd better prescribe you that particular medication because it's got a really good profit margin that they enjoy. Legalized marijuana is the future of the United States. We are moving in that direction. We're moving there very slowly, but at least now that Jeff Sessions is gone as Attorney General, perhaps we can move a little faster. But pharmaceuticals kill American citizens. And it's not just, oops, you know, this one pill had a bad reaction in a patient. It's that pharmaceutical companies know about the dangers of their products and they push them out there anyway because they understand that however much they have to pay out in lawsuits is always going to be less than the amount they pull in from profits. So they push new, more expensive, and more dangerous prescription drugs on us, a lot of times for conditions that they actually just invent. They say, oh, well, this normal part of life is now a medical problem, even though it doesn't, you know, cause you to die earlier or really any horrible things happen. But now there's a pill for it. So pay us $500 to $1,000 every single month and we'll take care of this minor inconvenience you were experiencing. In states where medical or medical and recreational marijuana have already passed, prescription drug sales have fallen by 11%. People are using it to treat things. Glaucoma, chronic pain, nerve disorders, PTSD, anxiety, sleep disorder, nausea and vomiting from chemotherapy. The list is endless. We already know that cannabis oil can actually help control and even prevent seizures in children suffering from certain conditions. The list of things that this can treat is endless. This is not about saying, hey, let's let everybody get high all the time. It's not necessarily something I'm in favor of. If that's your choice, go for it. Do it safe. What I am in favor of is holding big pharmaceutical companies accountable and letting medicinal marijuana come in and help people who are not being helped by traditional medicine. There's always going to be a place in this country for big pharma. We do need the medications they put out. They are very important and they do and can do great work. They've let greed take over. By bringing in recreational and medicinal marijuana, we can break that greed stranglehold that they have on this country. And perhaps after losing a little bit of money here, $6 billion a year there, maybe then Big Pharma will start to understand that they need to get back to making medicine to fix people rather than making a quick profit for their CEO.